Parasites are one of the most feared aspects about the raw diet, both by pet owners who are curious about feeding raw food, as well as many vets. Parasites are, of course, a valid concern when feeding your pet raw flesh, but they can be avoided through a few simple measures. So in this video, I'll be going over three common parasites that can be found in raw meat, and then go over a few ways to prevent parasitic infection when feeding raw. Number one, Toxoplasma gondii. In humans, Toxoplasma gondii is one of the most common parasites in the world, infecting over 60 million people in the US alone, oftentimes without any symptoms. It can be found in contaminated water, on contaminated surfaces, and in wild animal feces. This parasite can also infect wild and domestic animals, with cats being their most favorable host. When it comes to raw meat, this parasite can be found in contaminated pork, lamb, venison, rodents, or shellfish like mussels, oysters, and clams. As just mentioned, Toxoplasma gondii can affect all warm-blooded species. However, felines are the only definitive host where this parasite can actually mature and reproduce. According to many veterinary articles, dogs and cats that have a healthy immune system may not even show signs of infection. However, immunocompromised pets, as well as puppies and kittens, may show symptoms like fever, diarrhea, coughing, difficulty breathing, jaundice, and possibly seizures or death. To prevent toxoplasmosis in your raw-fed pet, it's suggested to not allow your pet to consume wild prey right away, though this can be difficult if you have an outdoor cat. Many cats that regularly hunt may never be affected by this disease, while others might. Again, a healthy immune system plays a large role in whether or not your pet shows symptoms. If the meat you're feeding is questionable, meaning wild-caught, not sold for human consumption, or sold from a facility that isn't regulated to prevent this parasite from infecting their livestock, it can be killed by freezing at 8 degrees Fahrenheit for 3 to 4 weeks. When it comes to shellfish, it's suggested to feed them cooked or steamed to not only eliminate the risk of toxoplasmosis, but also other possible infections that shellfish might contain. Number 2, Trichinella. Pork is a meat owners often worry about when raw feeding, and trichinosis is one of the main reasons for this. Trichinella spiralis is a parasite commonly found in certain carnivorous animals, such as bear, fox, or cougar, as well as omnivorous animals like domestic pigs or wild boar. This parasite has also been noted to be in horse meat as well. In most cases, trichinosis in domestic and wild animals goes undiagnosed. However, pets affected by trichinella can experience diarrhea, muscle stiffness, and inflammation. In the US and Canada, infection is mainly, if not exclusively, found in wild boar when it comes to swine. The number of cases in domestic pigs has gone down significantly after stronger enforcement and more control over their diet. To prevent trichinosis in your raw-fed pet, if you're in the US and Canada, only purchase pork designated for human consumption. Store-bought pork is often sourced from larger facilities that have safeguards in place that prevent parasitic contamination. But if you're sourcing from a more local, smaller source, ensure that they enforce these safety precautions as well. If you're in a country that may not enforce these same precautions, it's wise to freeze the meat for 20 days at 5 degrees Fahrenheit to kill any worms. I always suggest not to feed wild boar, as they often carry viruses that are freeze resistant. Number 3, tapeworms. Tapeworms are one of the most common parasites owners fear when thinking about their pet eating raw meat. There are many species of tapeworm, with a handful that can be contracted through contaminated waters, feces, and wild animals. But the four main tapeworms found in commercially raised meat are Tinea saginata, or the beef tapeworm, Tinea solium, or the pork tapeworm, as well as Tinea hydatigena and Tinea multiceps, which are found in sheep and lamb organ meat. An additional tapeworm called Dipylidium caninum is actually the most common tapeworm that's found in pets, and this is regardless of the diet. Did you know that this tapeworm is contracted by swallowing a flea infected with a tapeworm larva, not from raw meat? This tapeworm can often be identified by seeing rice-looking segments in the pet's stool and is easily treated with a dewormer. In general, tapeworms found in raw meat typically don't cause significant illness in dogs and cats, according to capvet.org. However, treatment is always suggested. To prevent tinnitus in your raw-fed pet, don't allow them to scavenge on wild animal feces, as the eggs are often shed in the stool. Additionally, according to the Mayo Clinic, freezing meat for 7 to 10 days at a temperature of negative 31 degrees Fahrenheit will kill tapeworm eggs and larvae. But because home freezers don't often reach temperatures below 0 degrees Fahrenheit, it's suggested to freeze these meats for up to 4 weeks. If you're feeding whole prey animals, especially wild whole prey, as an addition to freezing for 4 weeks, it's also wise to remove the digestive tract, as it often just contains fecal matter and provides little to no nutritional value. Now, what's the bottom line? Parasites are a very real risk that I do not want to downplay to cater towards a fresh food agenda. However, it's important to remember that these parasites can be contracted from sources other than raw meat as well. These parasites can easily be avoided by following a few steps. Not allowing your pet to eat animal feces or drink from questionable water sources. Feed meat from facilities or farms that have safeguards in place to prevent parasitic contamination and produce meats for human consumption. And finally, freeze questionable meat at 0 degrees Fahrenheit or below for 3 to 4 weeks. If you're curious about bacterial infection from raw meat, such as Salmonella, check this video out.